What's up, y'all? Welcome to the stream. Today I'm going to be working on making a Droidsmith so he's actually an interactable character, an AI. He actually comes with you for a minute. You take him down to the lower levels of the ship and he has to repair some stuff. It's going to be pretty... he plays a key role in the plot of the video game called Songbringer. So, oh, let me get this all set up. 30 FPS, and okay, there, the volumes are good. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and save the game right here at the Droidsmith's lair. Head Droidsmith in. Jagundrarum on Kaslaw. I hop Nagra Avara Zocker. What's up, Sound Dogs? Ahoy, man! Okay, so, yeah. The goal today is to get the Droidsmith so he can have an IHOP. It did sound good, right? What would you get? I would get a big waffle with some red raspberry and some cream, some like whipped cream, and probably some bacon and eggs, too. I mean, you can't just have a waffle, can you? All right. So let's, still getting used to Vim here. But I guess last night I had this crazy explosion of competency with Vim. I don't know what happened, but it just all suddenly clicked. So we're going to create an item for the Droidsmith so he can not necessarily be possessed, like you possess him as an item. It's just more that this item represents the fact that he's following you currently. You go with waffle and omelet? Omelet. Oh yeah, the podcast isn't out yet. It was recorded yesterday, but it's going to be like a few weeks before it's actually released because he's got a backlog. Yeah, they just haven't posted it yet. I'll definitely let you know when it's out though. I'll put it on my Twitter and I'll be talking about it on the stream, I'm sure. Yeah. Okay, so we got item Droidsmith. And create the item Droidsmith. Yeah, man. So how you been today? What's going on? Item Droidsmith. Droidsmith. I don't know what. I think it should be probably be like 4. And doesn't count. There, now we got Droidsmith created. I think that should be all for a minute. I'll start compiling now. Been a lazy Saturday. Awesome. I love lazy days. Okay, so we've got the item Droidsmith. The next thing will be so we can convert the Droidsmith into an active Droidsmith or else just convert his mode. No. See, I do this already for Vel, where when Vel comes out of the cryo sleep, she converts from an entity that's just sitting there into an entity that can follow you. So, I guess it's going to be in Create Heroes. Create Heroes. One thing I haven't learned how to do in Vim yet is to jump to a function name. Jib's gonna get jealous. Yeah. I'm hoping Jib likes it. We'll see. He might get a little jealous. Create heroes. That could do it. We're also going to need an AI for the Droidsmith. Like, similar to Vel. So, let's do that. Copy data. Friends. Vel to data. Friends. Droidsmith. Okay, now we got the Droidsmith. Let's edit that. Data, friends, Droidsmith. Okay, so we'll give him the name Droidsmith. He's never gonna die, but we'll keep this no Z order on death. So you can have a shadow. No need to have the shadow offset. Total input health. Actually, let's just give him regular health. But health flags. Instant recharge. So he never takes damage. He's got collision category friend. I don't know why she had friend neutral, but friend neutral, I guess that's fine. Takes damage from those kind of things. That's okay. Can't walk on any of this stuff, except the Droidsmith can fly over the sky. Should be good for speed. Why did it highlight that in red? That's weird. Excel, decel, we can play around with those. What do we got already for the other Droidsmith? Oh, can't read it. I gotta change that. It's so deep. How do I change my Vim? What's up, Boogie? Man, this is a total brain. It's a brain workout, man. I'm trying to learn to Vim. Vim said tab width. I think it's command tab stop. So what if I did that in this Vim buffer set? Tab stop equals 2. That's the thing, man, right there. That's cool. Set tab stop 3. I know option 3. It's pretty good. Cool. Let's make that a Right, what do I got on here? I got such a low reputation. 337! I'm not very active on there. So let's make that official. Man. Tab step equals 3. I think I need to do it here too. Set tab stop equals 3. Okay, cool. Now we got some better tabbing. All right. What else? So here's the Droidsmith as he was. Oh, these are the children. Apparatus. Item place. Wait, where's the actual Droidsmith? Maybe just be called Smith? No. That's weird. You got a lot. You've been a member for 5 years and 7 months. We both need to do our civic duty some more. Answer a few questions on Stack Overflow. Did I create something? Oh, there it is. It's called Smith already. All right, so we want to edit data neutrals Smith. Ah, man, Vim is so hard to use sometimes. Kira, yes, right? Yes, gotta share whatever I know. That's what I'm trying to do this stream for. Okay, this is kind of going too slow here. All I really want to do is copy some text from here to here. I know, right? It's always been answered already. I know, right? The off-topic thing? I've asked many questions, too, on Stack Overflow and have them flagged as off-topic. I'm like, what do you mean it's off-topic? Okay, so now he's going to have a shadow. Input health. Collision. It's a different size though. Here's his size. He's gonna have a move mask. Before he had none. Speed 200. Excel. Decel. And a dialogue component. Okay, so we don't need this collision or move. Still got the name Smith and render. Sit good old animations he had before. And other thing, I want to copy all of Vel's AI. To the Droidsmith. When you tell you your question is going to cause a riot, right? What's with that? Why can't I ask a question? What does it matter if it causes a riot? Okay, the Droidsmith never dies, so he doesn't need like a swoon or alive. Teek, what's up, man? Yo, welcome. Let's see, what's this human thing? Oh, that's when it becomes human controlled. Okay, so the Droidsmith never gets controlled by a player. He's always automatic AI. He never combats, he always follows. Wait, what's Rai again? I know I should know what this means. I still don't know what this means intuitively. Programming technique which binds the life cycle of a resource to the lifetime of an object. Is that like reference counting? It still doesn't, that name really just doesn't seem to define itself very well though. It's like, what does that mean? Sequence to follow. If mode one, target hero. And stay targeting the hero. Just pathfind if mode one, dir any. I'm not sure if he needs dir any there. Oh, this is where he gets stuck and he wants to choose another path. Stuff about putting resource acquisition into object constructors. Huh. Path target. If you're stuck, pathfind. Right? Combat update, we don't need this. Combat fire, don't need that. Don't need combat stop or combat stuck. Sequence follow. So we'll call this one mode 8. So the Droidsmith will, by default, his AI will not be running because he won't be starting in mode 8. But if we trigger him via a story element to start following you, he will, start following you. Because it will trigger, it'll get into mode 8, and then mode 8 will target hero, and then we'll set mode 1. So it gets into this two pathfind thing. And stop if we're in mode one and we're close to the target. following if mode one. Back up if mode one. If mode one. If mode one. Okay. Got some initial AI created for the Droidsmith now. Putting resource cleanup into destructors. Okay. So it's just a fancy way of saying loading stuff from a constructor and unloading stuff from a destructor. Alright, now the next trick this should still be fine, right? If I run this, the Droidsmith shouldn't have any problems being how he is. He seems to be happy. Let's see if I can craft anything. Let's craft, already crafted a lot of stuff here. I want to craft the poison with the ghost sword. We'll turn off the ghost sword. Okay, I'll go back to using Vim now that I got this created. We got smith.txt. Wait, let's quit. Start over. Here we go. Basically, yeah, that's the thing, huh? Oh, but it's that every single resource needs to be an object. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's like blind faith or blind coding. You're just doing stuff because you think you should. Which, yeah, I'm sure it makes sense in a lot of contexts to do that, but does it every context? Probably not. Okay, we'll go to here. Poison sword, where are you? There it is. And run it. Oh wait, shit. That needed to be a two. Can't we craft you? Oh, cause I what? No, not poison sword two. Ay yay yay! Poison sword zero, man. Ghost sword two. Whew, what a brain workout! Trying to learn Vim. So far, it's kind of cool, though. I'm really liking how Vim is fast as hell. Even for, like autocomplete. Other little features like that. Just making sure the Droidsmith can still craft items. Yeah, he's like, whoa, I can do this. Good. Okay, so next thing is to transform him into an entity that can follow the player. And Vel does that when you get item Vel. Vim has its own built-in autocomplete, but I'm using a plugin for it called You Complete Me. I know it is. It really is that ugh feeling too. It took me, oh, now it's been about a year and a half of I switched all my keys in Songbringer, so when I'm moving the character, I'm using Vim keys, J, K, H, and L. So I finally got really confident with that part, right? But so I can move the cursor really well. Look at this. Wow. Just pressing H, J, and all that. That helped a lot. But it took till last night. I had this crazy breakthrough last night, and I was like, whoa. Just suddenly figured out a few things, like how to move your cursor from the beginning of, like, the end of one line to the beginning of another. That's such a little thing, but it's off by default in Vim. Farpoke, what's up? It's the reason you started messing with Clang? Yeah, because like it has a lot of built-in Clang auto-complete-y stuff. And that's what this thing is that I'm using. You Complete Me uses Clang to complete stuff. So what could I do here? Words. So I can complete that. Okay, behave is see how fast that is? It's like faster than Xcode. And apparently I can get it so it can even fill in arguments too. I'm not sure how to do that, but I might need to. It's part of some new branch. Like for example, let's say I had an entity. I don't know if I have entities in this file. An E1 or something. E.render. No, I don't have entities in this file included. Let's go somewhere else. Anyways, I'll start coding here in Vim today. We'll see how it goes. Oh yeah, and how it handles Unity builds. I know this is the reason why I've kind of wanted to break through with Vim for a long time. I'm like, if I can figure out Vim, I know I can have a faster workflow because I can because everything is customizable in Vim. Oh, I know, right? It works really great for Objective-C. That's so lame. Yeah, as long as you're using Apple's languages, their autocomplete works great. Okay, so we need to go to the point where it creates heroes. Or wait, no, the first thing would be to go to story system. Damn it. Yes, mandatory XKCD. Please give me some more. Is it worth the time? How long can you work on making your routine tasks more efficient before you're spending more time than you save? Ha! Across 5 years? How much time you shave off? How often you do the work? Nice. So wait, if you shave off 30 minutes and you only do it monthly, then you have to finish the task within 5 hours. XKCD. Here's where we create Vel. If you're giving the player the item Vel, it will go and find the existing Vel and then delete it and then create heroes and set the position. You do? So it looks like some good guidelines, good thing to have on your wall. So I should make this a function because I'm going to reuse this. So we're going to convert the entity Droidsmith into the Droidsmith. No, wait, no, we're not going to do it that way. Oh, shit, this is a good way to do it. So, because Vel, Vel, does Vel have? This one flag, so she has. No, she doesn't have this one flag that keeps her entity from being deleted by the area. So it's just the fact that create heroes function creates her that way. Okay, so yeah, we can do this way. We'll turn this into a function. Overwatch is free, yeah? Oh, I should get it. Get it while it's free, man! Even though I don't even play 3D games. Oh, you can just play free for the weekend? So after this weekend, you can't play anymore? Meh. Hmm. Oh. Oh, it's Windows only? Okay. Well, that settles it. So we'll call this function static void convert hero the old name, new name. How do you? How do you block indent something in Vim? Or do you use that command? So I mark it, and then I use that. Oh, okay, that's pretty easy. If you're copying, oh, and you can align it. That's kind of cool. Okay, cool. So if I select all this, and then use this key, oh, I broke it. That didn't work. So So yeah, so far I'm not really competent enough to like switch from Xcode to Vim. But I'm closer, I guess. Maybe I just didn't, maybe I have to have the options set for this command. Shift width, maybe. I don't know. Looks like a Pixar movie. Okay. So we'll take the entity's old name. This is pretty freaking sweet about Vim. Watch this. I can go delete in parentheses, and it just deleted everything within those two parentheses. Wow, except for the other parentheses. But anyways, you get the point. No, wait, no, that was right. Yeah, we needed that. Okay, so name component find old name. I know, right? Me too. Vim is difficult. I'm not gonna lie. Vim is not easy at all. Nothing seems intuitive too. If like, especially if you come from a background of using your everyday editors like Notepad and Xcode and Visual Studio, even Emacs. None of, I don't think Emacs is moded. So Vim is moded, and it's crazy unintuitive if you don't. If you're not like raised that way, you know, you have to really rewire your brain to think this way. But I think in the long run, it's more efficient. So we delete the old entity. Okay, there we got a convert hero function. Now, when we create vel, if item equals k item vel, you can't autocomplete that. It's got like every other item, but not vel. Go figure. Convert hero from vel floating to vel. Okay. Now I want to test that. Make sure I didn't break vel. Get some water. No kill bombs. Now I'm pressing semicolon Q to try and quit the game. Vim. I really have a love-hate relationship with Vim so far. Okay, I need killer bombs, super bombs, super. You did? Okay, cool. Yeah. That I didn't break her existing functionality. All right. So dude, just auto load the file every time, Vim. You got it. Come on, Vim. Make it easy for me. Here we'll create the Droidsmith. Same thing with the Droidsmith. Oh, now it's got Vel? What's with this? Convert hero from Smith to Smith. Yeah, sorry about that, Kira. It's on my end. Yeah. It's part of my script right now. It goes and it tries to press. You know what? Maybe I can just fix that really quick. Vim! So frustrating. God, there. Okay. Hammer spoon. Hammer spoon, Nidlua. There's something. It's the Xcode run command. Oh yeah. I'll just take that off though, because it's pressing escape twice so that it doesn't in case I was trying to run a command. Right? Isn't this the one? I think yeah. So I'll just comment those out for now. And I should be able to go back over here and it shouldn't go beep beep each time. Yeah, okay. There, no more beep beep. That XKCD is totally my life right now. I spent like 2 hours last night doing something that saves me like, I don't know, 5 seconds. 50 times a day. Bye, beep, beep. See ya. What is this scratch preview window? I don't know. Okay, now the create heroes method needs to create the Droidsmith as a hero. If you have the Droidsmith item and it's set to 2, that's in area creation. It's going to be very similar to Vel. Do Smith is if we're not doing jib. No, wait, yeah, you can have jib or Vel. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so we can do Droid Smith just as long as we have the Droid Smith. Now it works. And as long as it's 2. And if we're in the swordless dungeon, always set it to false. Oh, that's an error, huh? It's trying to tell me there's an error on this line, even though there's not. So many little weird things. So many little weird things. What a brain workout. I'm going crazy here. Douche Smith. Would have been a lot funnier if I did. Yank. I did just actually say yank. And that is actually a Vim command. Yank. I think pull is pull a command too? Or now it's paste. There's definitely yank. Joy Smith. Name equals Smith. Id. Oh, what the. Oh, this is getting really annoying. This one little bit here. I gotta change this right now. Vim. Vimrc. There's this command. I don't want the down key to help with the autocomplete. This is the super beautiful thing about Vim, is that you can customize literally everything. And there's plugins for just about anything you could think of. All right. Open up area creation. And oh man, I love how it remembers exactly where I was in each file. So great. Okay, id's name component find name. We're finding the Smith. If the id equals 0. And do. What's up, baby? I'm streaming. Yeah. Yeah. Do you just want to get something for yourself? Oh, no, I'm okay. I'm all right. All right, baby. Okay. Okay, so if we are trying to create the Smith, and there's already 2 heroes. This is need to be if this is greater than 3 now. This would be 2. Never say no to food. She didn't want to get food. She's like, She sounded like she just wanted to come straight home. Besides, I'm not even hungry right now. But that's not at all. That's not at all smart, is it? Of course not. I'll be hungry in like 15 minutes. I'm sure of it. We don't need a gear component for him. Not setting the player id. Yeah, you're on your own. Cook your own I love leftovers, so I know we already have leftovers anyway. I'm banking on what's in the refrigerator bank. And here we go. So we're putting the Droidsmith into mode one. And then adding it as a hero. And destroying the smith if we don't have the item anymore. Okay, let's run and see what the hell happens. If we have a Droidsmith already, that's going to be a bad thing. Did it just build twice? Oh no, it built and then built. Or built and ran. Okay, good. We don't have the Droidsmith. But what if we did? Let's try and get the Droidsmith. See what happens. Rocket Bunny, what's up? Yeah, Visual Studio for Mac. I heard about that, but I haven't checked it out. Let me check it out right now. Has anyone tried it? I'd rather use Vim, obviously. Oh man, such a love-hate relationship with Vim right now. I'm trying this, man. I'm downloading it at least. It's only 20 megs, man. I'm not trying it right now, though. No way, Jose. But later on, when I have a moment of free time to try such frivolous things. So the item is called Droidsmith. We'll give it to the player. Cash it, what's up, man? You can now use a compiler on an OS I don't use. Oh right. The installer's only 20 megs. So, does anybody see a Droidsmith on the screen? I don't. Oh, wait, there he is! He was there! Holy shit. There he is, the Droidsmith! What's up, buddy? What you doing? And he just, like, comes with you. So, he's not animating his idol at first. And he doesn't follow you. Why is he not following? I thought he's supposed to be in mode one. Get out of the way, man. Jeez. You obviously never saw VS. Oh, it's totally true, Farpoke. Yeah, I'm realizing that, right? Everything that you want to do requires like 3 or 4 keystrokes for things that are like quick as hell in Xcode. I can press Control O and then boom, be it whatever file so quickly. to do that in Vim, I have to go like colon B, blah, blah, blah. The great part though is that once you kind of like have established how you work in Vim, then you can go back to your Vim RC and set those up as shortcuts. So you'll never have to type those things in. I'll just have to assign them to some shortcut key or key combo. He went exploring. he's like, Rock, you're always trying to craft the stupidest shit. Let me help you out. Yeah, cash it. I hope it does. I hope it gets easier. I had like a pretty good breakthrough moment last night. You can say the same thing about Dwarf Fortress. Oh man, I've never played that. I really should. So okay, why isn't he getting into his what mode is he starting in? Tabs in Vim? I haven't tried tabs. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. What are you doing? I can't turn the cup into a fire cup. The lazy noob pack. That sounds like a good thing. I'd probably like this whole... I like the way it starts. Lazy. It's a good word. Okay, now we gotta get this guy to move around and follow you. Why is he not moving around and following you? See, now is when I need to start a... This is super annoying. Help W11. Whoops, not W1. Help W11. The file which you've started editing has got another timestamp. Auto read. Auto read. I want auto read on. Have you ever tried Manjaro Linux? No, I haven't. It's a branch of Arch. I don't know. I wouldn't be messing around with Arch until you really got a good handle on other simpler OSs. Arch is crazy. You got to rebuild everything from scratch. I guess it'll teach you a lot if you really want to do that. It will teach you a hell of a lot to build your own OS like that. Well, you should probably start with something like Ubuntu first. Oh, really? So tabs versus there are different concept than buffers versus tabs. Hold on, is it just set auto read? Set auto read. Did it do it? I don't know if it did it. Let's run the game and see. The stream keeps glitching. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, so if I save the game, quit. Yeah, it just auto-reads. Yay, Vim. So you just got to kind of get things all set up the way you want it in Vim. And then it starts getting really awesome. Like, what the fuck is going on here, though? Why are you inserting all these eyes when I'm trying to press tab? the fuck? Trailing characters? I hate you, Vim. I thought we were having a moment there, Vim. Set auto read. Okay, there. Now it'll do that by default. Where were we? Where were we? Trying to get the guy to... Okay, so we need to set a breakpoint. Now here's the part that kind of sucks. I don't know how to set breakpoints in Vim. I'm sure there's some kind of plugin there where I could set a breakpoint and it would like run GDB or something. But that's kind of going beyond the scope of what I know in Vim right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and set a breakpoint normally in Xcode. Doesn't create heroes. We're creating this myth successfully, that's for sure. I just want to see if it gets its AI variable. Entity ID is 3. Shouldn't have a... Oh, it does have a profile. AI. Active, true, good. Behavior should be full. Yeah, parse true. Children, values. Okay, it looks like he has an AI. And his mode starts at 0. Well. So why isn't he kicking into his VI? Wish I could help you there, bunny. Data. Friends, neutrals, Smith. Okay, AI, why aren't you kicking in? Sequence, oh, he has to be in mode 8. That's right. Duh. Yes! Oh, he's fast. What about if you get blocked, man? Can you get around that? That's too... Oh, yay! Pathfinded! This is great. This is super great. Why isn't he running his idle, though? He's got an idle animation, right? Idle. Smith idle. Yeah, he's got that. What would cause him to not idle? Do you have a different skin? Probably not. Let's make him a little slower. Oh, he's fast. He should be slower than that. Slow. But seriously, why doesn't he run the idle animation? He starts running it. Maybe he doesn't... Man, this is hard. So, what's going on in my brain right now is I think of what I want to do code-wise, and then I have to think about how I'm supposed to do that in Vim, and then I lose my train of thought. I'm like, shit, what was I trying to code again? So that's what's so such a brain workout. What was I gonna do again here? Shazzle. And I haven't even smoked weed in 2 months. Oh yeah, it's idle animation. So do other, yeah, okay, so render component. There something that loads idle? Use profiles, idle animation. Oh, for that's only for a sprite frame though. Oh no, there it is. Set animation K idle forever. Yeah, it's what's happened right there. Use profile. Use profiles true. If we have the profile string, oh, as long as we don't have image in the Droidsmiths. Droidsmith. Yeah, we don't have the image thing. Okay, it's not doing that. Right, it's so much easier just to set a breakpoint here. So right before I create him, set a breakpoint there. Render component. Shit, man, I can code so much faster. Xcode here, set a breakpoint here, turn this one off and run. My, think I need to take a little Vim break. All right, we got a name string Smith, profile string empty. Use profiles false. No skin, no image string, but we do have a name. So we get the profile Smith, get sprite frame for idle skin. This should work. Let's see if this profile's loaded. True. Yep. Can we get this sprite frame from this animation? The anim key is idle. This should be totally good. Anim successful. Get sprite frame. Anim frame number 0. This should totally work. And it has 4 frames.
What's up, baby?
You right? Okay, yeah, there's 4 frames. It should successfully return a frame, and it does. So we have a frame, and we should have used profile because the frame's not null. There we go. It sets the animation to idle right away when it starts. Does that work? Seems to. Oh. I think I know what it is. Because he's a hero. He's probably trying to run his idle or his run animation. So Smith, yeah, see, he doesn't have a run animation. Duh. All right, so run is Smith idle. I think so, Rocket Bunny. You might need a percentage sign after the variable too. That's weird. He's still stuck again. It's like, But then as soon as he starts moving, he gets his animation. Yeah, Droidsmith! This is cool. Okay, we need to make sure that he plays nicely with Jib. Don't thank me until it works, right? Oh wait, that time he was fine. This is great, you got Jib and the Droidsmith. Well, wait a minute, how did the Droidsmith get all the way over there? That was weird. What are you doing? It keeps warping around, I think because of the way it handles multiple entities. In fact, that's probably what's going wrong with him in Tick Heroes. The Droidsmith has joined your party. All right, so it's going to be making sure everything is working right with a flux CPP. I think it'd be a nice place here to transition him into from his existing place in the Droidsmith chamber or room or whatever to an active entity. So let's go back to the ship. I'm ditching Vim for a minute because I just want to be able to code for a second and not be constricted by relearning everything. No Droidsmith. We need a story entity for this to happen, though. So we'll go to story.cpp or story.text. Hey, you guys haven't seen the bridge yet, have you? At least on this stream. Check it out. You guys got to see the bridge. Captain Tusk. And Rosenbaum and Guildenstern. That's what these characters are named over here. Yeah, so there's going to be a lot more story to this, though. Like, when you first get here, he's going to ask you, what the hell happened? You know, why haven't you responded? And you'll explain how you got crashed on your bike and stuff. And then he gives you a comm so you can actually communicate with him. And whenever he wants to communicate with you, he just appears like a hologram next to you and can talk to you. So that'll be cool. A little NPC that can like appear. Right? You suddenly don't feel sad the pizza man isn't the captain anymore? Good. I'm glad. So this right here is Rosenbaum, and this is Guildenstern. And they'll have their own personality too. I'm imagining a lot of little funny elements happen here with them interacting with the captain. The captain's gonna be like a super like egoic kind of character. Yeah, he's got a feather in his cap, and he's got a tusk that he's wearing as a necklace. Pizza Man is still in the game, yes, but he's not on the screen anymore. They're going to be down at the party that will happen on the overworld, so that'll be kind of a whole nother week where I'll create that, where there's a party going on the... they take one of their away ships, and they take it down to the planet's surface, and it's got speakers on it, and everybody goes there and has a party. There's like a DJ, maybe a little band. And so that will be a place you can find on the overworld. Like Captain Zap Brannigan? In some ways, yes, but I'm imagining not quite as dumb. Alright, so yeah, let's get the story element happening so you can get the Droidsmith ship. Ship Smith. Oh, you thought Rock was the owner? He's part owner. Yeah, he's part owner. So the captain is a part owner, Rock's a part owner, and there's a few other people that are part owner too. Smith. We got Smith 1, Smith success, Smith fail. We'll call it, this call this one, Smith join. Donald Trump quote said by Zap Brannigan.
It would take an hour and a half to learn everything there is to learn about missiles. I think I know most of it anyway. My wife, Ivana, is...
Oh my god, I gotta watch this later. I wanna actually listen to this. Yeah, with the big wallet. Isn't that great how video game characters can hold so much stuff in their pockets? Exist Smith has Droid Smith. I think we want to do pattern ship Smith. Yeah, ship Smith. Oh, couldn't. Oh, that's why he's the co-owner. Oh yeah, it's partly a party ship, but yeah, it does actually have a mission. So it's not really a mission, but it's more like what they do is they go around to different planets and map them and then sell their maps. So that's how they make a living. So that's why Rock's part of the scouts that goes and scouts the planet, makes maps. They go back, they sell it to the highest bidder, that kind of thing. And then they have parties too. All right, now we just need to do actions. Dialogue, Smith, join. Item, Droidsmith 2. Map things party the whole time. Right? Yeah, man. Maybe they sell photographs too. They're like, check out the pictures I took. This exotic planet. I think that'll work. Now we just need a little bit of dialogue. Smith join one. Don't know. Just have Jib say something real quick and see if it works. Oh, we do need to trigger it to happen by having Droidsmith 1. So we'll have to have like another character will trigger this whole quest or whatever to happen. The captain will trigger this all to happen. Like he'll say, "Hey, there's something going wrong with the doors or the engines or something like that," and you have to go down to the lower levels of the Songbringer to figure out what's going wrong. He's like, take Smith down there, figure it out. It worked. Sweet. Where are you going? He's given up on following. He's like, see, I'm just gonna go down here in the corner for a while. I'm gonna pout. I'm gonna pout in the corner. Still doing it. Okay, so the code needs to be better about creating characters. And having more than two characters follow you. Checking in so far, though. Yeah. Oh, we don't need that anymore. Remove data, friends, Droid Smith. Make sure I didn't just delete that. Cool. Okay, good place to check in. Yeah. Good idea, Mutinous. Surveying and map making. Good call. All right, to start the code, so he's smarter about, well, what phases are we talking about here? Phase slide is a good place to start, where it slides from one area to another, and it's probably not going to be smart about how it does Jib's position. Hello, Lucas. Right. You changed the art style? Let's check it out. Cool, man. Nice progress. It all makes sense now. That's why they party so much. All right, so this is the problem. Right now it's only setting the hero position for the second hero, not possibly the third hero. So we need to do a loop over the heroes. What's up, Yellow? So for each hero, if this hero is already the hero the Fluxiad is probably easier, more universal way to do this here, Fluxiad. And we continue. Otherwise, we're going to set this entity's position. So old hero pause for HID. Flux ID. Okay, so it's basing it on its position delta compared to where it was. Before it started the flux. So that should be all. And then we might not even need Jib. Oops. Oh, here's where we sync the hero's position later. if the hero we deserve. So we need to make this code smarter too, so it loops over all the heroes again. Oh, I forgot to open up that Vim video link. Is it good? Is it the dude that's super passionate? Oh, learning Vim in a week. Nice. Oh, how to do 90% of what plugins do with just Vim. I saw that link. I'll check this one out, though. This learning Vim in a week one. Oh, I've seen this guy. Yeah, I've seen this one before. Yeah, that guy's cool. The Dark Knight. Who utters that line again? Was it that police guy? My name is Vel. Yeah, the learning Vim in a week. That one. That's the one I'm talking about that I've seen before. The other one, I definitely should check that out. How to do all that stuff without plugins. New hero pause, HID. Get any valid pause, HID. New hero pause, HID. H dot collision dot size. H dot move dot mask. Okay, we should have things set up for this. So it'll kind of be more universal about all the heroes. We could have as many heroes as we want now. We could have 10 people following Rock across the screens. Right, memorizing what he wants to do. Mm-hmm. Oh, change. Yeah, inside is a super powerful command. Like, delete inside the parentheses. Quotes inside the parentheses. Oh, they worked. Yay! But Jib and the Droidsmith are getting stuck on top of each other. And then the Droidsmith just goes off in the corner. Like, I'm done. He did it again. He just walks through the walls. He loves that corner. Right? It's like, I don't want. I've been stuck in this room for the whole game, and now you're making me just walk around and do nothing? Alright, I'm trying to find the bit of code where it puts Jib above the player. It's like it's consistently putting him. Yeah, he was going through walls too. Yep, I think he might have got stuck on something, which allowed him to move onto a wall. All right, we'll do the same thing here. He's a fourth-dimensional being. Well, walls can hold him down. It's just that he moves into the fourth dimension and goes around him. So here's where it puts like Jib and the Droidsmith to positions that are based on the hero's position. Was this supposed to be hero ID? I think I might have messed that up. It's lore. It's not a bug. Oh, there is no code that moves him. Oh, Jib and the Droidsmith are both moving directly onto the player's position. So I think this should be if this is not Jib. There's like a murder of crows outside, making a murder of crow noises. So look, he works fine at first. He's following. He's pretty excited about it too. He's like, yeah, let's go. Oh, and then he gets stuck in a wall. Oh, now he's still okay. What? Oh, look, he's totally fine. That fixed both of his bugs. Yay! I love bug fixes like that. He's going through walls, though. So it is possible you could have Vel right now and the Droidsmith. So I'll need to make sure that's okay. Oh, there's also something else where it's... We'll make this a little more universal, so if the entity has no gravity, it automatically puts them above ground. And speaking of, the Droidsmith should have no gravity. Just like Jib, no gravity. Oh, it already does set the hero positions. Okay, these are all set up right now. It would kind of be nice to have a macro now to be able to loop over all the heroes that aren't the main hero. Because I'm starting to do that so much that it's just nice. It would be nice to semantically compress that. So let's do that. For each. For other heroes. Auto it. And we'll give it a var name. Oh man, how do I do that? I want to go continue the loop if there's not. How would I write this into a macro? Oh, writing a macro would make it fast, but writing a function would make it proper and much easier. I'll just make it a function. Static void for alt heroes. This takes a const function, which takes, returns void. Wait, void. And takes a const int ref. Auto ref H in game scene heroes. If H.id is not equal to flux id, run the func on H. Run the func. Pets, huh? Sounds like fun. What's up, HD? Yeah, pets. That could be fun. Definitely to add that. Heroes. So we can use it here in this slide function. Loop over. You're good? Awesome. For alt heroes, this function that takes an int. Already would be much easier if this wasn't a constant. Although I hope that's possible. Is that okay? Probably not. No, it doesn't like that. All right, it's got to be a constant. So there, now that's just a little cleaner and easier to write. Okay, make sure we're still on track. Things are still running how they were. Oh, that's right. It has to become a lambda now. Boo. Oh, man. I didn't mean for this to be this complicated. I guess I could capture these variables though. We're on Steam already. How long have we streaming? Oh, no wonder. Been streaming for 2 hours already. Cool. Droidsmith still follows. You probably shouldn't have a collision component. Like, it's kind of not cool that you can get stuck on him. He goes wandering again. Stuck Wander. He gets really, really stuck if he ever gets into Stuck Wander mood. Let's see why. Wait, what? Okay, it's no longer there. What gets you into that stuck wander? Oh, he gets into stuck, and he gets into mode 3 and then never gets out. Oh, because he goes back to mode 0. He's supposed to go back to mode 1. No wonder he's getting stuck. The boops are back. I booped it. Boop, 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 boop. Now that's the sound the Droidsmith makes. Songbringer going to be end up released 80 to 90% finished with finishing touches a few months later? No. By the way, almost 5 years later, and Terraria just released crossover content with two new experimental features. Nice. No, Songbringer is going to be finished before it's released. Yeah. I've kind of looked at the way some games have been released. Like, in particular, I was watching how Hyper Light Drifter got released. And so many people were upset with a lot of things with Hyper Light Drifter, 60 FPS. You know, they were griping about that not being there and a lot of other little issues that weren't. They didn't really fulfill all their promises they made to their backers and things like that. So I don't want to make the same kind of mistake. So Songbringer is going to be a 100% finished before it ever gets released. I want people to play the finished game as it's meant to be played, not wondering and waiting for the developers to go and finish the game. I think that's a real big mistake people are making these days with their games. Especially with early access games, they're just leaving them in early access forever. And you're always, as a player, you're always wondering, is this game ever going to be finished? When will it be finished? You know? I don't want to do that to players. He started wandering. Okay, yeah, he went into his wander, but he got out of his wander. So that's cool. All right, so I guess it's going to be it for today's stream, guys. Do you have a good definition of when it's finished? I do. Yes. Sorry I can't really elaborate more on that. But yeah, I have a pretty good definition of where I want it to go with the story and all the bosses and all of the enemies. So yeah, it'll get finished. Yes, it does. It still has glitches. Tons of them. So thanks a lot, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll keep working on this Droidsmith tonight, so see you, everybody.